Hello guys, welcome to my channel Salesforce Bolt. In today's video, I'll explain how you can get the parent ID if you are overriding the standard functionality with a lightning component. In my today's example, I'm overriding the opportunities new button functionality with a custom lightning component. And on the load of the custom lightning component, I'll be getting the parent ID. Okay guys, so let's get started. I'll be sharing my screen now. So guys, for today's example, I have already created a blog also. I have already uploaded my component code and controller and helper also there, so you can just directly go and check out there if you want, and I'll be trying to explain it in more details here. Okay, so in my case, I'm having opportunity and accounts here, and on opportunity new page, I have overridden the functionality with one of my custom component. Okay, so let's go to account first. So in account, as you can see, I'm having one testing account here. Let me just open it. Okay, from this testing accounts related list, I'm trying to creating a new opportunity, guys. Okay, so on the click of new button, these are my record types, record type 1 and 2. Let's click on next. Okay guys, as you can see, the parent ID is printed here, and in the URL, guys, as you can see, like, you the record type ID is here, and apart from the record type ID, we are having some additional parameters here. There is one additional parameters named additional params here, in which you can see there is account ID here. So basically, we are getting the account ID from the URL. We are decoding the URL and extracting the account ID. Let me show you how I'm doing this. Okay, so this is my component, guys. In my component, I'm having lightning is URL addressable to get the variables from the URL, and I'm having one attribute to save the record ID. The another one is for account ID, and I'm having a handler here. The handler will work like the page load, and I'm having the parent a p tag here, a paragraph tag here, to just print the parent ID. And after the parent ID, I'm just printing the variable here. Let me just show you the page load function do init. Okay, so in my controllers do init, guys, what I'm doing here, I'm getting the URL parameters using some custom codes here. You can check from line number 3 to line number 18. This is the code if you are getting the URL parameter from the desktop version of your component. Basically, there are two versions. One is desktop version and second one is Salesforce One application. Like, if you try to run it in a mobile application, so it will run a Salesforce One application in which your page will open. I'll show it to you guys. Okay, so these line of the code you can use, like, if you are using it from a desktop version. And underneath that, from line number 21 to line number 47 are the code if you are using it in a Salesforce One application. Basically, we have to combine these codes in a single function. Like, suppose some of your user could use it in a desktop version, and some of them can use it in Salesforce One application. So that's why we need to combine these code into this one function here. So as you can see, guys, here I'm just getting the parameter from the URL by decoding the URL. And to decode the URL, I'm having a function here. Let me show you. In my helper class, I'm having a function getParameterByName. Using the getParameterByName, I'm creating custom regex here to get the parameters from URL. Okay, and in my controller here, I'm just getting the parameters using the page reference attribute here. And for the Salesforce One site, I'm just decoding the URL. And after decoding the URL, I am splitting the parameters with the help of JavaScript. As you can see here, guys, I'm using substring here. Like, from the URL, I'm doing substring to get the particular parameter, and as well as with the substring, I'm using index of function to get the particular index of that parameter. So basically, I'm just splitting the URL to get the particular parameter. Let me show you the URL. So this is the desktop version of it, and let me just show you the Salesforce one version. Okay, so for Salesforce one version, let me just open the console here. Okay, this is the mobile version. Let me reload the page. Okay guys, this is the Salesforce one version of my page. Let me just get back to the page from accounts. Okay, here is accounts. Here is my account. Related. Opportunities. Okay, now I'll create a new opportunity. Yeah, here is the button. Now this is my record type page. Let me click on the continue. Okay, you can see the parent ID. Guys, if you have noticed, like we are having the record type ID parameters here, but the additional param parameter is missing here. From the Salesforce one application, I'm just getting this in context of reference parameter, in which we are having, I think these are our parameters decoded. We have to these are our parameters encoded. We have to decode the URL to get the parameters from here. Let me show you my logs here so you will be able to understand it better. Okay guys, in my logs, as you can see, I'm getting a value here. In this value, I'm having encoded URL string. After decoding the string, I'm getting the string as a JSON format. And in this JSON format, as you can see, I'm having my account ID as ACC ID here. Okay, so after getting the JSON string, basically what I'm just doing, I'm just splitting the string using the substring function, and I'm just getting the index of this ACID using the index of function of JavaScript. And after doing the substring and getting the index of the function and splitting the string, I'm getting my account ID here. Okay, so that's it guys. That I think this is the easiest way to get the account ID from the Salesforce one URL. And the same way in my desktop version, let me show you the logs. Okay, let's make it full version. Okay, so in my desktop version also guys, I'm having the decoded string here. I'm just encoding it in JSON format and I'm getting my account ID. So guys, if you have any questions, so you can just comment down below. I'll try to revert back as soon as possible. And to get the complete code, you can just visit my blog here. I have already uploaded all the code on my blog. I'll be sharing the link in the description, guys. Hey guys, I hope you liked this video. Please share it with your friend and hit the subscribe button if you find the content useful. I'll see you in the next one, guys. Till then, bye. Jai Hind. Peace.